السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله الذي تتحير دون إدراك جلاله القلوب والخواطر، وتدهش في مبال إشراق أنواره الأحداث والنواظر، المطلع على خفيات السرائر، العالم بمكنونات الضمائر، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أياما كلما نودي أجابا، وبجلاله يمشح السحابا، وكلم في الدجى موسى بلطف كلاما ثم ألهمه الخطابا، ويا من خص أحمد واصطفاه وأعطاه الرسالة والكتابة ثم قربه وسماه حبيبا، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله الأكرم الأولين والآخرين على الله ولا فخر، وسيد ولد آدم ولا فخر، وأول من تنشق عنه الأرض يوم القيامة ولا فخر، وأول شافعا ومشفعا يوم القيامة ولا فخر، وحامل لواء الحمد بيده وأول من يدخل الجنة ولا فخر، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وقد قال الله تعالى: أينما تولوا فثم وجه الله. وقال الله أيضا: والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله، والذين آمنوا أشد حبا لله. وقال الله في حديث قدس: يا ابن آدم أنا لك محب. يا ابن آدم أنا لك محب، فبحقي عليك قل لي محب. وقال الله أيضا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد كلما ذكره الذاكرون وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. All praises are constantly due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the giver and the taker, the one who has perfected his creation flawless from any defect, the most gracious, the most merciful, the most unique, the most wise, the most powerful, the most kind, the most forgiving, the most high. Choices, peace, blessing, and salutation be upon my beloved, your beloved, our beloved, Muhammad Rasulullah. The one who was sent to this world as rahmatan lil alameen, mercy unto the entire creation, the most exalted in Allah's creation, the most elevated in Allah's creation, the most unique in Allah's creation, the most loving in Allah's creation, the most beloved in Allah's creation, the most outstanding in Allah's creation, and definitely the most beautiful in Allah's creation. Join me in taking this moment to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us yet to see this other day of Yawm al-Jum'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our presence in here. Amen. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and pardon those of us who could not make it due to unforeseen circumstances. And those of us who could not make it due to illness, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them shifa kamila. And those who have left us physically, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend ease and comfort in their grave. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the highest abode in Jannah. Ameen. Thumma ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaikum. Inshallah, in the next few moments, I will discuss a virtue. A very beautiful virtue. A virtue that is deprived from understanding. A virtue that can be used as a weapon. A virtue that encompasses all virtues. And through this virtue, all the virtues are unleashed and clearly understood. We speak of this virtue being a weapon. A weapon in what sense, brothers in Islam? In a sense that we as believers can defend ourselves against trials and affliction that our brothers, such countries as Syria, Iran, Afghanistan, and our brothers in Palestine, and not forgetting Kashmir. But then, how do we expect to be helpful or to be beneficial to our brothers when we as Muslims, we as one nation are divided? We as Sunnis are divided. You find that the problem went to an extent that even families are divided. You find that this family was called Ya'az, but because of the division they had, now it's no more Ya'az, but Saba Ya'uz and Saba Ya'az. Why is it so? Because we have lost the essence of love. We have no love for one another. A saying comes in mind, sweep your house before you go sweep other's house. Before we go and help brothers in Kashmir and Palestine, first let's help ourselves. Let's create love amongst each other. Let's go back to the story of the Muhajirin and Ansar. Allahu Akbar. Look at the love they had for each other. The Ansaris, before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to propagate Islam to them, it was considered two groups, Awad and Khazraj. They were both not connected, they were enemies. But when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to deliver Islam to them, they became connected and they were given status of Ansar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught them what? How to love each other. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught them that. How to be united. How can you be united when you don't have love for each other? Why are you divided? Don't you share the same creator? Why are you divided? Don't you have the same Rasul? Don't you share the same kalima? That's the problem. We have lost the essence of love. We forget the aspect that this entire universe was built with love, started with love, and our very existence only continues with love. So take away love from anything and watch it collapse. Look at our situations now. We have no love. That's the reason we are being divided. The love is not there. In pre-eternity, this world of diversity and plurality came into existence out of love. And we as mankind and jinns have been created in such a way that our passion for love can only be satisfied through the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing else. You can never find love in this dunya. Some of us think this dunya, we can fall in love with our cars, subhanAllah. Wallahi, this lies. You love satisfied. Why? If today you have a Porsche, you wanna, you know, work hard to get a Bugatti tomorrow. Allah says in the Holy Quran, Allah has beautified for mankind. So all this thing you want, wallahi, it's not forever. Why? مَدَاعُ الدُّنْيَا خَلِيلٌ. But then if you come to Allah, your Rabb, my creator, our creator, if you give your love to Allah, what you gonna get? جَنَّاتُ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ. You gonna get Jannah. You gonna stay in Jannah. And what is Jannah, brothers? Allahu Akbar. Jannah is a place that no eyes has ever seen. Jannah is a place that no mind ever thought of. Jannah is a place that no heart ever perceived. You're gonna get Jannah. Jannah is a place you're gonna live forever. And what is dunya? Dunya is a place where you just live temporary. One day, we have to leave this dunya. So give your love to Allah. Give your love to your creator. He's gonna give you everything. Not only Jannah you're gonna get, وأزواج مطهرات ورضوان من الله. Now, what happens if you give your heart to Allah? What happens if you give, you know, You entice soul only for the sake of Allah. That happens. Yani, you know, we when we have somebody, and you know, we have our different ways of exclaiming or you know, proving our love. But then Allah's love is different. Allah has stages, categories. Allah first says in the Holy Quran, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind. That's for the entire universe. Jinns. The entire universe. The kafirs. The Jew. The entire universe. But if you continue to become good, to worship Allah, to believe, Allah says, Ya ayyuhan ladhina amanu. All you those who have believed, no more ya ayyuhan nas. You are now all you those who have believed. If you keep becoming good, Allah says muttaqin. If you keep becoming good, Allah says muslihin. If you keep becoming good, Allah says muhsinin. Then if you keep becoming good, doing more zikr, Allah says inna ibadi, O sir, my servant.
Allah.
Why my servant? Why not all servants or all you believer? Why not all mankind? But all my servant, because Allah is happy with you.
Allah
is proud of you. Allahu Akbar. And if you continue being good, doing extra ibadat, what Allah says, Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim. You become Allah's friend. Allah says, only my friends do not fear. So from ayyuhan nas, from ya ayyuhan ladhina amanu, from all mankind, from all believers, from all my servants, Allah now put you in the category of what? My friend, you become Allah's friend. Allah says, man adali waliya, faqad adantuhu bilhab. Whoever hates, whoever is the enemy to my friend, I declare war upon that person. Allah will be with you wherever you walk. Allah will be with you always. And for the friends of Allah, for those who are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it's time for them to leave this dunya, what happens? Allah calls them. Allah is happy with them. Allah says, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsu al-mutma'innah, yirji'a ila rabbik. Allahu Akbar, look at this beautiful hadith that came in mind. You know, this hadith, if you think about it, probably you can feel faint. Because when Allah loves you, He calls Jibreel alayhi salam. Who is Jibreel alayhi salam? Jibreel is an angel that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw, he fainted. Why? Because of his wing was covering the horizon. Jibreel is an angel who is the greatest amongst all the angels according to Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Allah will call him and say, Oh Jibreel, I love so and so. I love Fulan. Imagine if Fulan is you. Imagine Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Oh Jibreel, I love Adam.
Allah.
Imagine Jibreel alayhi salam saying, Oh Jibreel, I love Abdul Majid. Not only that, but Allah will command Jibreel to love that person too. So what will happen? Allah will love you and Jibreel will love you. It doesn't end there. Jibreel will call all the inhabitants of the Sama. Who are they? All the malaikas, we can't even count them. It's beyond our comprehension. There are trillions and trillions. And Jibreel will say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves so and so. So I command you to love this person. So who will love you? Allah will love you. Jibreel will love you. And all the heavens in the angels in the heavens will love you too. Look at the love. Hazrat Hussein had that Yazid offered him everything, say, I'll give you anything you want, everything, but only in one condition, just take my bay'ah. But he never wanted nothing from this dunya. What he said? He said, no, he never wanted anything. After all this, he refused. He kept striving in the path of Allah. Why? Because the love he had for Allah. With these few words, I would like to end my lecture by giving the same. I'm saying that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated, that if you respect Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you knowledge, through knowledge. And then when you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning when you're loved by Allah and you know Allah, what will happen? Your du'as, when you ask Allah, your du'as will make the mountain move.
Allah.
In Hadith Qudsi, Allah says, when he loves a servant, what happened? كُنْتُ سَمِعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes the eyes that to see with. And whenever you ask Allah